All right. He needs to open this one on film for you guys.
I might fail because I'm not used to the whole, you know, superior German assemblies and whatnot, but.
Oh my God.
I got him.
Oh, brought back memories.
I didn't know that was going to happen though.
We are back, and today I was like, hey babe, let's do some beer tasting and let's taste some German treats. So that's what we're gonna do for you guys tonight. Where'd you go, babe?
Globis.
He went to Globis. I have not been there before, but I got these so that you guys can actually like see the beer, because I feel like if it's down here you can't see it. So excuse the ghetto-ness of this setup, but at least you'll be able to see it.
It's
and you'll
improv.
Be able to see us.
It's improv.
All right, so the first one that we have is called a...
That's a Radler.
A Radler. So this is the juice mixed with the beer.
I believe it's juice.
Okay.
Like 75% positive.
It looks like lemon juice.
You want me to pour you up?
Sure.
Okay. I guess this one is made by Krombacher. So we'll see what it do.
That is enough for a taste for me. Thank you. We're just doing a taste.
I told you it's like mostly juice.
Oh my gosh. But you're just tasting it either way.
You're just tasting
it. Oh my gosh.
Who's got to drink the leftovers?
Who knows the leftovers?
All right.
Okay, so let's see.
It's super light, kind of like...
What is it? Prost? Prost?
Prost.
Prost.
Yeah.
What's that's like, good.
That's good, like for like after like Sunday morning.
Mm-hmm. Sunday morning.
Well, I'm thinking football. It's American football season.
For me,
Saturday morning soccer. You know.
For me, I feel like that is delicious. If you can see it, this will give you a better view of it because we kind of held it to ourselves. If you can see it, it's kind of like. Light color, wheat color. I am not a beer connoisseur, so I'm just gonna give you the real, like a real woman who drinks beer sometimes and likes the flavor of it, but does not know all the in-depth stuff about beer. So if you want that type of opinion, that's me. He knows more than me.
I don't know more than her. I just drink more of it than her.
To me, it tastes like lemonade.
Yeah, you don't really taste the beer?
No. Not at all. No beer. It's delicious. Yeah. I like it. It's delicious to me. It tastes like...
It's pretty good.
Yeah, I think it tastes really good. So
it could be scary, I guess. Let's see what the alcohol percentage is. 2.5, that's why.
Oh, it's hardly anything in there.
Yeah, so like a Bud Light would be usually 3. So it's less.
Oh, so this is like a cooler.
Maybe.
Something like that. So this is good if you want, if you don't like want to get drunk or anything and you just want to go out with your girlfriends or something or guys. Juice mixed with beer, I mean, it's juice. It tastes like juice. I can't hardly taste the alcohol in it, so it's good for me. I love it.
Good for me too. Oh, I guess if I'm going out with my girls.
Okay, next up we have Park.
That's a red label.
This is the red label. The other one was yellow.
Green.
Green.
And I think Park is like close to us. It's a somewhat more local beer, I believe.
Not that much beer, just for a taste.
That's you a taste. That's
the last taste. Time I was struggling to get it all down because we still have like 3 more to go. So let's just do a taste.
Yeah, just a taste.
No, babe, this, well, you can do what you want.
Get out of here.
Oh Bert. My gosh, sorry. I'm not the beer police.
It's because I don't have to drive home.
So this right here is... still a yellow beer. Would you say amber color?
Yeah, it's like a, it's another one, like kind of like a lager or pils. Let me see, what is this? What this is? False. Pfalz? Or is that that's where we're from, huh?
I don't know, but this one definitely tastes more like beer. I feel like I'm drinking a beer. I feel like I'm drinking a Bud Light. All I need is the lime. So this is Bud Light minus the lime. It's delicious.
Oh, it's a dark lager, I believe.
Mm.
Yeah.
To be a dark That's lager, dark. Does that look dark to you guys?
I think dunkel is like dark. And I recognize lager.
If you hear our kids in the background, I'm sorry. They're going to be here. They're a part of us. We will never be without them because...
Do you like it?
That's how I am. I do like it.
How are you going to score it?
A 7.
I'm clocking in at a respectable 5.2?
5.2, why?
Percent alcohol.
Oh, what's your score?
So my score will get, let me try it again. It's pretty good. I'll give it the same, 7.58.
You give it a 7.5?
Yeah, or 8. It's definitely something that you could just have like maybe 2 of them or whatever and not get bored of the taste.
Yeah, and as you see, I already have finished my... What we got here?
It's a Kristall.
Oh, okay, JC. From 93. Go ahead and open it and pour that up for us.
Yep, let's do it.
All right, while we drink Kristall.
It does have like a little, I say that the label's kind of fancy. Like they get that platinum, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, a plitty plat?
That platinum color, you know what I'm saying?
All right, well, I will take some. What do you know about this beer? I know you don't know much about each one, but.
Not a dang
thing. Not a dangy dang thing.
Yeah, I don't know about this beer, honestly. Other than, smells like beer.
Go ahead and like this video if you know stuff about this that we don't like, know about it, and then go ahead and comment if you can teach us some stuff, because we're learning, we're Americans learning, we're giving honest opinions, so teach us, help us. Be nice though, because if not, I'm gonna delete your comment, and that's just facts. All right, so this one is another amber color. Look, I'm using my nursing urine. I'm comparing it to urine.
Why would you do that?
This is amber colored, I would say. Like, all of them so far have been pretty light. You didn't get me anything dark.
So, no, I had a dark beer earlier today, and it wasn't that great.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
What was that?
I don't even remember what it was called. But I won't be having that again.
Toilet water. That's what I want to call it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a little spicy, huh?
Ooh.
Doesn't it have a little bit more bubbles?
Aye, aye, aye.
Oh, what's the Power Rangers? Is it Reba? No, Reba.
This is delicious. It has some spice to it. Hold on.
Oh yeah, it zings the lips.
Okay, so if this was a soda, it would be ginger ale. Warm ginger, because it's warm right now. Warm ginger ale.
I think it's called Kristall because of the bubbles, maybe.
Something.
It's like the champagne of beers.
I can see myself.
The most American beer I've had out here.
Yeah, I can see myself on the porch in my down south house when we're going to retire somewhere down there, drinking this.
Really?
Talking to my grandkids. The vibes. Got grandkids vibes.
So I'm gonna score this one like a 6. Because it's just a little plain Jane to me. I can see other people liking it more, but it tastes like American beer, and that's where I'm from. Mm. I've had so much of it, you know what I mean?
For me, so you know when they say, like, do you want your water, what is it, like, fritzy?
Oh, yeah.
Do you want it fritzy or plain?
Flat or spicy. bubbly, right?
We are so
sparkly,
good.
Sparkly, sparkly.
When they say that, like, which way do you want your water, spicy or not spicy here in Germany?
Caliente.
I like fire. This would be the spicy version of a Bud Light. Okay, guys, so this one is, what is this, babe?
That's the other park.
What park did we go to before?
We went to the red park, the premium export.
I'm so confused.
Oh! Yeah, right here.
Okay.
So that, yeah, this is the green label.
Alrighty.
And I believe there's a significant difference.
Let's see.
From what I hear on the streets.
Prost.
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 Prost. Prost.
Prost.
We'll get it.
Pricka.
We suck. I mean, but we're new. You know what I mean?
Look, don't judge us. Watch this 4 years or 3 years from now and see how we do.
By the time we biz out.
See how we do.
Come on.
At that
Let's
point.
Go.
All right.
Well, I think beyond the taste, it's a smoothness for me.
Butter.
It is smooth like butter. The bubbling action, as you can see, I'm not gonna say I do a perfect pour, but your boy's up there.
No head.
It.
Is that what it's called?
It's the head. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I mean, it's just all the way down smooth. The taste is there if you like the taste of beer. It's got everything you want. Like, you could base it in your brats for beer brats. That's flavor right there. If you feel me? That's flavor right there. Or you could just drink it like I'm gonna do. And that's flavor right there.
So, ladies or gents or whoever is not an exclusive beer drinker, right, yeah. Levi? I think that this tastes like Corona. Boom.
That's like okay,
that might not be helpful to people. I'm just thinking now, like, that might not be helpful to people who
are in Germany.
Right.
I'm pretty sure they know what Corona is in Germany.
Yeah. Okay.
They seem Fast and the Furious.
Boom. So this is like Corona. A there good it taste. It's mild flavor.
It tastes like family.
It tastes like family. It tastes like a nice beer that you could have with a quesadilla. I would pair this with a quesadilla. I would pair this with, it's like, it tastes like a Mexican beer. I might be way off. I'm just going by how I feel.
Oh yeah, it's definitely a German beer.
Yeah, it's, I mean, it's a German beer that you can go to a German, you mean like Mexican that restaurant. Okay. And
like Corona, I think it was a lager. So you're saying it's like really close to that, like that beachy vibe? You get beachy vibes from
beachy.
The beer?
Beachy. I want to wear a bikini right now.
I want you to wear a bikini right now.
All right. He needs to open this one on film for you guys.
I might fail because I'm not used to the whole, you know, superior German assemblies and whatnot, but.
Oh my God.
I got him.
Oh, brought back memories.
I didn't know that was going to happen though. This is a Munich, I believe. Munchner Hell. So it's a Hell's. From Bayern München, Munich.
Did we show it to them? We didn't even show it to you guys.
Yeah. And I heard really good things about this brand.
Let me show it to you guys.
I also do not know how to say this brand. Hacker. you try to say that. Pschorr. Pschorr. I don't know.
Mm-mm.
But
that's giving me Blue Moon.
I think Blue Moon is a wheat beer or something like that. You know what I'm saying? I think they on that same level.
This is how we do it. Ooh. It's Friday night. I know I'm talking
on
about
Wednesday.
Blue Moon is a beer that has like orange hints and like.
Yeah, but I feel like
if you've never had it.
This one might be like where you're saying hints, right? Blue Moon is like a punch in the face. With the orange, like they're throwing oranges at your face
and they're putting oranges in it.
Yeah, definitely.
So if you wanted to trick some customers
or fat tire or whatever, same thing in my opinion.
Yeah, and it was like it was the end of the night and you ran out of Blue Moon, you can give them this, but you can't give it at the beginning of the night because they're gonna know it ain't Blue Moon, but at the end of the night they're not gonna know. That's what this is.
Call it a refreshing beer. Like I would drink this after a PT test. Like I feel like it's hydrating me right now. It's giving me strength.
So we brought the whole family over because everybody was acting crazy on the other side. It's like they can't be separated from us or something. I don't know what it is. Gigi, where's your pacifier? She got it in. Yep. This is a headband, guys, by the way. She likes to, let's see how long she can keep it on. Let's see. Okay, so what we're going to do right now is we're going to taste some German snacks that my hubby got from Globis. So let me show you what they are. He's like ready. So this right here is some nachos. Ay, ay, ay. Smoky, I would say.
I like that. It gets better as you chew it. Yeah, good. You like
I have something that tastes like this.
He said,
I have something that tastes like
this. I feel like we had something like this at Aunt Judy's house once.
To me, it tastes like a rice cake nacho.
A little bit ricey.
It tastes like a rice cake mixed with a Dorito if they had a baby. Okay, so now we have the soft cakes. Boom. That's how they look.
Are they soft?
We'll see.
All right.
So, Gigi gets one.
She ain't even doing her shit.
Sorry, we had a man down. Cameron's a little sick, so he needed to cough and stuff, so he went upstairs. So now we're eating this. Take a look at this. I'm excited.
Is it yummy yummy? No, dead ass.
I didn't even give Levi one. That is wrong.
I gave Levi one.
What do I want to say about this?
I told you it was gonna be a banger. I looked at it and I saw it and I was like, that's a hit.
So this is like raspberry. So the raspberry gives it a tart hint. And then you have the chocolate, which is definitely like, it's not a dark chocolate, but it's almost dark chocolate, I would say. And then you have a soft.
Yo, I'm hiding these. You ain't gonna see them again.
Little cookie. I would say like a little, what would you say, like a butter cookie?
It's like a cakey, cakey cookie.
A cakey cookie? Mm-hmm. Like, not very strong flavor because everything else is strong flavor. Delicious.
Levi, do you like that one?
You like it?
I think that's like a chocolate, like crispy wafer type deal that's rolled up.
Long roll.
I think a lot of companies, there's a lot of varieties of this type of sniggity snack.
It's pretty.
Not bad either.
It just tastes sweet.
What?
To me, like a sweet.
The outside tastes sweet, but the inside tastes chocolatey.
Like a sweet chocolate.
The chocolate's good.
It tastes like a sweet wafer. This tastes like if you were drinking a German coffee and you wanted to sit this right on the side of it, like a black coffee. Really? Really? To give yourself something sweet, this would be the sweet thing that would hit with it. What do we have next?
The last one. Off top, gotta go unicorn.
Candy Mandy.
Vegan, you know what I'm saying? So it's technically healthy.
Is it?
Technically, right?
They're just not eating meat or anything from meat. That doesn't mean it's healthy.
I don't know. They all claim to be healthy.
Ah!
Wow.
It is so sour, but it's not a hard chew. You know how you have some gummy things that take a while to chew, stretchy, get all over your teeth.
Oh no, that's right to the point, ain't it?
It's dissolved in a matter of minutes. Like you chew it, you get what you need. And that's that.
No, I ain't gonna knock the vegans on this one. This one's straight up and down.
Oh my God. So we hope you enjoyed our little fam bam.
And I enjoyed it though.
We loved it. We're gonna have a fun rest of our night. If you want to like, comment, and subscribe. And we'd love you to be a part of our team. And
if you're not with the team, you know what I'm saying? You with the enemy team.
And if you don't want to, then just go ahead and watch more of our videos. Thank you for coming by.
Yeah, I know.
Say bye-bye, Gigi.
Bye.